All right, we're going to go on to our weekly national reminder. Now, be it during morning rush hour or the evening dash home, you are bound to be rudely accosted by random, normally dark-colored SUVs with blaring sirens and strobe lights. Now, back in 2015, such motorists were to be arrested and their vehicles impounded after a directive by the then Interior Cabinet Secretary, the late Joseph Nkaiseri. But 6 years later, they are still harassing motorists and barging their way through Nairobi snarl-ups. Unhindered, that is. So, what became of the directive? And what did the police intend to do about it? Our very own Victoria Ruby Dewey reminds us on this week's National Reminder.
On January 12, 2015, the then Cabinet Secretary in charge of the Interior and Coordination of National Government, Joseph Nkaiseri, directed that any vehicle found to have a siren or strobe lights, apart from those allowed by law, will be impounded and their owners charged in court. The law the late CS was referring to is Traffic Act Cap 403. Under Traffic Rule 83, within the Act, drivers should give right-of-way upon hearing sirens indicating the approach of police vehicles, ambulances, or fire engines. In addition, under the NTSA Highway Code, drivers should give right-of-way to the presidential motorcade. The directive sent out via a press statement was swiftly acted on by the then acting Inspector General of Police, Samuel Arachi, a few days later.
Now, this is now an order to all commanders countrywide and the traffic department that effective now, any vehicle that is not a police vehicle, is not an ambulance, is not a fire engine with a strobe light and sirens must be impounded. They could be cabinet secretaries, they could be permanent secretaries, governors. Those vehicles must be grounded forthwith. We need to lead by examples and observe the law.
The stern warning came days after Mike Sonko, who was Nairobi senator at the time, came under sharp criticism for harassing other motorists with his chase cars. Now, in February, the National Assembly, in an attempt to add other VIPs to the list of siren users, passed the Order of Precedence Bill 2014, which was forwarded to the Senate for consideration. Among other things, the bill allowed for former presidents and former prime ministers to be allowed to use sirens on their motorcades and processions. The bill is yet to be assented to, however. Several years later, and the Nkaiseri directive on sirens and strobe lights appears cold dead. Government vehicles and private SUVs supposedly carrying VIPs are back on the roads in full force, terrorizing motorists and compounding Nairobi's already bad traffic situation. May 30th, 2019, following public outcry, Inspector General of Police Hilary Mutyambai had issued a directive granting special road clearance to a select list of VIPs. Those accorded the privilege were classified into five categories. The first tier contains the President, Deputy President, First Lady and Cabinet Secretaries for Interior, Defense and Foreign Affairs, as well as Interior PS. The second tier had the Inspector General of Police, Deputy Inspectors of the National Police Service, Chief Defense Forces and Service Commanders, while Category 3 comprised Speakers of the National Assembly, the Senate and Majority Leaders.
Retired presidents and the former Prime Minister, Raila Odinga, were in the fourth category, while ambulances and fire brigades were put in Category 5. Now, a few days later, the IG added the Chief Justice to the list of VIPs. Did it work? Well, during a spot check last year, and might we add, pre-COVID-19, nothing appeared to have changed. We followed this SUV bearing GK plates from the City Mortuary roundabout to the Intercontinental Hotel in the CBD. We were later told the vehicle was carrying a member of parliament who was headed for a lunch meeting at the hotel.
Now, as the current situation stands, as early as February this year, Nairobi Traffic Commandant Joshua Omukata, in an interview with a local daily, said police would soon embark on a crackdown on these SUVs. Until that crackdown happens, noisy sirens and bullying SUVs will continue being part of the traffic nightmare in Nairobi. That's your national reminder of the week, lest you forget.